4 of chapter 3, we're going to talk about muscle and nervous tissue, finishing off the 4 tissue types. So let's look at the outline for muscle tissue. You guys have a table that I made for you, so you want to know everything that's on that table about each muscle. Also, you want to be able to draw each muscle cell, so I have a little space for you underneath that table to draw. Let's just take a look at the muscle cells here, right? So this is basically what you want to draw underneath each kind of muscle. The 3 muscles you have in your body are skeletal muscle. This is the muscle that will move your body. So anytime you move your body, you're moving it with skeletal muscle. Your heart consists of cardiac muscle, and then your smooth muscle is the muscles that you cannot control. These are in your organs. So let's take a look at each one. We're going to begin with skeletal muscle. So skeletal muscle is very striated in appearance. It has a striped look to it, and those stripes are called striations. So you want to know that word definitely. Striations, so if you look at your table, striations is on the left-hand side. So skeletal muscle is striated, yes. The other characteristic of this muscle is that there are many nuclei per muscle cell. And so let's get into the muscle cell. The muscle cells are called fibers because the fiber is used to describe a long, thin structure, like a thread, or you know, a fiber that comes from your clothing. It's a long thread-like cell. So it's going to be long, unbranched, a cylinder, okay? And in development, many cells come together to create a muscle fiber, a skeletal muscle fiber. So it's going to have many nuclei throughout the muscle fiber, indicating that it was made through the fusion of different cells. So muscle fiber is the cell itself. We can see many nuclei, and we want to draw in some very strong striations. It's a very strongly striated muscle, and that's really a typical drawing of a skeletal muscle fiber. So the other thing you want to know about this is that it's voluntary, meaning that you can control it voluntarily, right? You can choose to contract it at will. So this is voluntary. All right, so any muscle that you can control at will is skeletal muscle. So any muscle that moves your body, in your legs, in your arms, in your back, in your abdominals, your tongue is skeletal muscle, your diaphragm, right? Because you can hold your breath. So even your diaphragm is skeletal muscle. The other thing you want to know about it is that it is regenerating tissue. So if you damage your skeletal muscle, it is able to regenerate. There are special cells that lie outside of the muscle fiber itself. So within skeletal muscle, there are other cells that are called myosatellite cells. So I drew one there. I'll draw one over here. Those are called myosatellite. And those are your stem cells that can regenerate damaged skeletal muscle. All right, so that's basically what we see in terms of skeletal muscle, and we want to recognize the image, the histology image of skeletal muscle. Let's look at our next and basic functions of skeletal muscle. It's going to move your body. So in terms of the position of your skeleton, right, it guards entrances and exits to the digestive system. This is because we have sphincters. So when you hold, when you squeeze your anal sphincter or urinary sphincter, when you hold it when you go to the bathroom, that's voluntary, right? You can control that muscle. So that's a skeletal muscle sphincter. And then it does generate heat, and it does have a role in protecting your internal organs, especially your abdominal organs. All right. So let's take a look at cardiac muscle, which is next. It's actually the last column in your outline. Cardiac muscle is uninucleated. So we have a cell that only has one nucleus. The cells are cylindrical and they branch. So I'll just draw a typical sort of cell here with a little branch coming away from it. And I'm going to draw one nucleus. Okay, that's one cell. So they're short, they're branched. Is it striated? So if you look at the images, yes, right? You can see the diagram is making a striation. In the actual histology slides, they're not that dark. I want you to look over in this area where you can see the striations over here. Okay, so yes, they are striated, but a little bit lighter than skeletal muscle. The other thing is that it is involuntary, so you cannot control the muscle of your heart. All right, so involuntary. And then we have our contractions are rhythmic. Is regeneration possible? No. So this is the downside of your heart, that when you damage your heart, if in a heart attack, that heart muscle does not regenerate. It does not grow back. So if you damage your heart bad enough, it's really a bad prognosis for you. If you look at special features, there are things called intercalated discs. So you definitely want to know this. This is the only muscle with intercalated discs, and these are little gap junctions. These are junctions between two cells. I'm going to draw a very strong line here, and then I'm going to draw another muscle cell, maybe another branched muscle cell with one nucleus. And that connection between those two muscle cells, that's an intercalated disc. It's a bunch of gap junctions, but it's a very strongly staining junction. So when you take a look at our histology slide again, notice that our intercalated disc is pointing to this very strong dark line here. If I look around, I can see more intercalated discs, right? I can see one here, I can see one here, 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 a few right there. Okay, so once you know what you're looking for, you can kind of see them. It's hard to train the eye, but once you get it, you can see them. Okay, so that's what you want to know about cardiac muscle. Cardiac muscle is only found in the heart. Now, let's look at our smooth muscle. Our smooth muscle is called smooth because it's not striated. The cells actually have a spindle shape to them. So you draw a spindle-shaped cell so here's that word, spindle-shaped. It's tapered on both ends, like this, and then wide in the middle. So that's your spindle-shaped cell. The nucleus, only one in the center, with a single central nucleus. Okay, so if you stack a lot of these together, like you see in the cartoon, it looks something like this, right? Oh, that was a bad one. Anyways, you know it. You get it. So this is our smooth muscle histology slide. This is out of the muscles, right? This one does not have any striations. We can see a very prominent nucleus, but nothing much else going on. So smooth muscle is, again, involuntary. This is going to be the organ muscle that we hear of. So the muscles that are in your stomach wall to churn your food, the muscles that are in your intestines to move and push your food through, the muscle in your bladder, the muscle in your blood vessels. So all of this is going to be a blanket word you can use is hollow organs, but the walls of your hollow organs, the function is what those organs do, right? So it either can move food or move urine, et cetera, et cetera. All right, so let's take a look at our next slide here. So this is our muscle types. Let's see if we can match the muscle types to the histology image. So again, our choices are skeletal muscle, cardiac muscle, and smooth muscle. What do we think this one is? That is skeletal muscle. All right, so notice there's striations. What about this one? So don't look here. This is not muscle. I want you to look in this general area here. Looks pretty smooth. That's smooth muscle. And then here is our last one. This is cardiac muscle. So this is a little bit, I would like to zoom in a little bit further to really give you a lot more detail, but we can look and we can see that we can see every once in a while, we can see some intercalated discs, right? Here. They're there. They're just hard to see when you're not trained to look for them. All right. And then also notice that the cells they don't look like they're all running in long parallel, right? They look a little choppy. So that's going to be your cardiac muscle. All right, so that is muscle. And the last tissue type you have is called nervous tissue. And the overall characteristic of nervous tissue is that it can conduct electrical impulses. And there are two kinds of cells in nervous tissue. There is something called a neuron, which you're looking at in this picture here. This is a neuron, and it conducts impulses. It's the kind of cell that generates the electricity. And then number two is called neuroglia. You can see that word here. And those are cells that do not produce or conduct electricity, but they help to nourish and take care of your neurons so they don't die. So they're really important. They actually outnumber your neurons 9 to 1. So for every 9 of your neuroglia, they're taking care of one neuron. So let's talk about the neuron for a second. You just want to know some basic parts of the neuron: the dendrites, the soma, and the axon. So the arrow actually here is pointing at these short branched projections, these processes. These are dendrites. So dendrites are usually short. They're usually branched, highly branched, and they receive the electrical signal. So they receive the electricity, the signal. And then the soma is also known as a cell body. So the soma is the main portion of the cell that contains the nucleus. It contains most of the organelles, and that's what we call the soma. And then our last projection or process that comes off of the cell is called the axon. The axon is where electrical signals go out. So this is the signals, or it's the out, right? Or you're sending out a signal to another cell. Okay. And axons are usually just one. Sometimes they branch, sometimes they don't, but usually one. And then there's some branching at the end, but we'll get to that in the nervous system unit. So there's a lot of other things going on here. Don't worry about finding the axon or the dendrites in a histology slide. I would expect you guys to know how to do that in a cartoon because it's very obvious, but in a histology slide, don't worry about that. All I want you to do in a histology slide, so if you take a look at this, this is nervous tissue, so recognize nervous tissue. So how many neurons do I see? The neurons are the big, big cells, and they have a shape kind of like this, right? So here's one neuron, here's another one out there, here, here, and here's one in the background. Now, those are my neurons. Where are my neuroglial cells, my smaller support cells? They're there. All of these little dots you see, all these nuclei, those are the neuroglia. So you can see how many there are. If you scan this image, a lot of neuroglial cells. Okay? So that is your task. When you see an image like this, I want you to differentiate between neuron and neuroglia. So don't worry about the other things. You can definitely see the nucleus here, right, with the dark dot in the middle. All right, I think we're done. There are some review questions, so we'll go over the review questions. The first one, tissue changes with age. So I did not specifically talk about this, but I think that you guys can probably come up with the answer. And the answer is all of the above. So as you age, the metabolic activity of your cells just goes down. So it's kind of like the energy level, everything kind of ratchets down. So if the cell is supposed to make more collagen fibers, it doesn't anymore. So your collagen fibers don't get replaced. The ones you have, get thinner, and it's just less upkeep and less reproduction and less damage repair. So there's less ability to repair your tissues. There's less efficient tissue maintenance. So tissues tend to thin and they tend to just become less efficient at what they do. Your epithelial cells, your epithelia doesn't replace as well as it used to, so the epithelial tissue gets thinner. So all the above, you guys. Epithelium is connected to the underlying connective tissue by, right, you should say it's answer A. Number three, connective tissue cells that respond to injury or infection by dividing to daughter cells that differentiate into other types of cells are. This is a little tough. What this question is describing is a stem cell. It's a cell that responds to injury by dividing to daughter cells that then differentiate to other kinds of cells. So the only choice here that is a stem cell is mesenchymal cell. Which of the following is or are functional characteristics of pseudostratified ciliated columnar epithelium? So your answer should be protection. Okay, protection. Permits expansion and recoil. This is a job of transitional connective tissue. I'm sorry, transitional, we're talking about epithelium. Epithelium. Absorption is a job of either cuboidal, columnar, or even squamous, but not pseudostratified ciliated. And no epithelium is vascularized, right? This is just a false statement because epithelial cells do not contain blood vessels. They are not vascularized. Which of the following is or are examples of dense regular connective tissue? So remember, dense regular, you have a regular arrangement of collagen fibers running in one direction. The strength is in that one direction, and you should have tendons and ligaments as your answer. Which of the following is a characteristic of cardiac muscle tissue? Okay, so if you need more time, pause, right? So the answer is going to be they are connected via intercalated discs. Cells are not multinucleated, they are uninucleated. These cells are striated. And the cells are considered to be non-striated. No, they are striated, right? And involuntary is correct, but this is the correct answer. In neural tissue, which of the following structures conducts outgoing messages? Okay, we just talked about this, so hopefully this is fresh. The answer is B, axons. Axons are for outgoing messages. This is just a little quiz at the end. This is kind of like your test you would expect. You don't see two slides on one for your exam. It's one at a time, but so name the epithelium. So whenever you see the word epithelium, you should think to yourself, this is a two aspect answer. I need to answer, is it simple or is it stratified? Okay, so layer, think about layer. How many layers is it? And then what's the shape? All right. So is it squamous? Is it flat? Is it cuboidal? Is it columnar? And then there's other things. There's the weirdos. There's pseudostratified and there's transitional. But those are the two weirdos, okay? So whenever you see the word epithelium, you think layer shape. How many layers is it? What shape is it, right? And those two words have to be present in your answer. So this one, number one, we look at this epithelium. Here is our free surface, right? That's the top. All of this down to there is epithelium. So I'm going to say it's many cells, right? So I'm going to use the word stratified. And then what shape do I see? Remember, I do not look at the bottom layer of cells for the shape. I look at the top. At the top, the cells are not square. They are not columns. They are flat. So this is our stratified squamous. Let's look at our next slide. This slide, there's a big giveaway, and that's these little hair-like things here. The only tissue that has cilia is pseudostratified ciliated columnar epithelium. So that's it. So whenever you see cilia, you know it now. pseudostratified ciliated columnar epithelium. Now, in picture two, there are other things I can ask you. I can ask you, what is this cell here, this white cell? You should be able to recognize this white cell. That's a goblet cell. What do goblet cells secrete? They secrete mucus, okay? I can also maybe ask you to identify this line. I can kind of see this line that runs along the bottom of my epithelial cells. What's that called? That is the basement membrane, okay? Or basal lamina. Okay, other things like nuclei, this is connective tissue. I could ask you where you find this in the body, like anything, any other tissue, but I thought I'd just explain a little bit for number two. Aha, now it's connective tissue. So now connective tissues, you have to switch gears. There's all different kinds of connective tissue, from blood to bone to cartilage. So you want to get that checklist in your head. What does this look like? That is blood. So blood will have these, most of these cells are these round, they look like bubbles, right? There's nothing inside, there's no nucleus. So what are they? They are erythrocytes. Then I see these cells that look very different. There's a couple of them in this picture. What are those? Those are our leukocytes, or white blood cells. Do I see platelets? Yes, platelets are tiny dots. Platelets are smaller than the red blood cells. So I can see a couple platelets here. I can see a platelet right here. I can see a platelet right there, one right there, one right here. So lots of platelets. Okay, so platelets are for clotting, but you can also use the word thrombocyte. What is this connective tissue on the right? So I notice that this looks nice and smooth. Some people might be tempted to say smooth muscle, but it's a connective tissue, it's not muscle, okay? So what is gonna have everything running in one direction? Dense regular connective tissue. That's that answer. Muscle, now we're on muscle. We have three kinds of muscle, right? So what's the one pictured here? That's skeletal muscle, very strong striations in skeletal muscle. We have a long cylinder-shaped muscle fiber. I can see it, a couple nuclei up close, right? Here I see three. And so that's skeletal muscle. What muscle type do we have here? This is smooth muscle. So notice I'm gonna flash back to the, see this? This is dense, regular connective tissue. That's smooth muscle. How can we tell the difference between the two? The nuclei here look barely visible. They look like they don't really stand out, but the nuclei here do, okay? And also the key, is it a muscle or is it connective tissue? All right, that's it. Good luck studying.